St. John 1 verse 1 says thus, "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God." Some will tell you, and rightly so, that St. John 1 verse 1 never read, "In the beginning was Jesus, and Jesus was with God, and Jesus was God." Others will go on further to say that St. John 1 verse 1 never read thus, "In the beginning was the Son, and the Son was with God, and the Son was God." But rather it states specifically, "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God." Many, while not denying that the Word was God, at the same time deny that Jesus is God, for some strange reason which I altogether do not understand. Perhaps in your responses you can clear up my misunderstanding concerning the matter. It's quite a reverse logic to conclude that the Word who was God was made flesh, but God himself was not made flesh. Let me ask you this. The Word who is specifically referred to and identified to be God in John 1 verse 1, did that Word cease to be God when that Word became flesh? Some Greek manuscripts have it like this: "And God was the Word." That is to say, God is identified eternally to be the Word himself. If the Word was made flesh and God was not made flesh, I ask the question in the reverse. Did God cease being that Word when that Word became flesh? Okay. To begin with, the Logos of God is really God's thought. It can also be regarded as plan, concept, or idea. Logos is not only a plan within God's thought, but Logos is God's very thought, making such Logos an aspect of God's very own existence. So, while it is not true to say that God is a thought per se, at the same time it is also true to say that God's thought is a part of his being, or a part of his person, a part of his very personal existence, where he and his thought cannot be separated. Make no mistake about this. We cannot separate God and his thought as distinguishable persons in the Godhead. It is quite absurd for any to conclude that while the Word who is God became flesh, at the same time God is not flesh, or rather never became flesh, because the incarnation, it would have to be assumed then that the incarnation created a kind of split where God and his Logos are eternally separated, because the Word was made flesh and blood, but the same Word today is now flesh and bones. So, if a corporeal manifestation of the Logos makes him a distinct person from God, that means God is eternally separated from his Logos. Now, is that logical? That more sounds like a kind of reverse logic to me. The very fact that God remains the Word at the incarnation suggests that for that Word to be made flesh, God, who is eternally with his Word, also has to be made flesh. Theos, there are some who will erroneously say that Theos means godly, on the basis that the definite article ho or ton was not placed before it in the last clause of St. John 1 verse 1. For example, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with the God in the Greek, which is in the Greek ton theon. In other places in the New Testament, the same ton theon is expressed as ho theos. And some will erroneously say that whenever the ton or the ho is removed from before the theos, then the noun is transformed to an adjective. Hence, it is translated godly and not God. Now, how erroneous really that could be? It could not be any more erroneous. Because in the first place, God in our Bible is not written as an adjective, it is written as a noun. And an adjective in the Greek, which when translated in English, has to produce an adjective in English. You cannot have a noun in English which is a translation of a Greek adjective. That's totally impossible. Theos in the Bible, whether with the ton or the ho before it or not, refers to him in the animate sense and is never expressed in the inanimate sense. If John had the idea that the word was God, actually means godly, he would have employed another Greek word, which is eusebos, which in the scripture means godly and nothing else. The truth speaks for itself. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Verse 2, the same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him. The him identifies not only the Word, but also God, who is the Word himself. Let the truth stand. Ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Let me hear your responses. Come on, Brother Ronald D. I give you the first chance. I enjoy talking with you, brother. You're quite astute and articulate in your exposition. God bless you, sir. Let me hear your responses. Refute what I have said if you think I am in error. God bless you. In Jesus' name.